took office in January and is the first woman and first
law enforcement officials across the state about metal theft. Each scrap dealer, when they purchase something from someone, are required to report certain things. They're required to take a picture, they're required to get a name, contact information, address, picture of the vehicle, picture of the items that were purchased. All of this is supposed to be done right then, loaded up online. That way, if a law enforcement official, Garland County, hears there's a report that something's been stolen, they can look through that. What we found out, that some scrap dealers, A, were not aware of what they were supposed to be doing, or they were not doing a very good job on their reporting. And so some of these pictures could have been taken from outer space, or you've probably gotten your phones back from a grandchild, and you're like, what on earth are you taking a picture of? And they're like, oh, it's that little thing out there. That's kind of, so we're not able to identify what the particular piece of metal is. Each one of those, and so our program is really a statewide coalition effort to work with local law enforcement. We've trained local law enforcement, I think in the last 2 weeks, I know we've done at least 9 cities, and 35 enforcement agencies already have participated in our program, where we teach them how to use the free, that's as in $0 cost, free online program that they already know how to use, it's called Leads Online, to search these metal theft or the buys of the scrap dealers. We're also training the scrap dealers on how to identify stolen metal, stolen copper, because it's important that we believe that if no one's buying that stolen metal, then the thieves will stop stealing. Already we have had successes in Jacksonville Police Department, for example, after one of their agents, officers had gone through our training, were able to solve a commercial burglary case and have arrested 2 people because of that, just because of the training that they went through. So we're hoping to reap the benefits of that new program right off the bat. So next, let's talk about the overreaching federal government. I am certain that at 8 o'clock tonight, every one of you all are going to hear quite a bit about that, but I want to talk to you all about what I'm doing as Attorney General and what your Attorney General's office is doing on your behalf to push back against this overreaching federal government. In February, I testified before a U.S. House committee regarding the EPA's 111D rule on carbon emissions, waters of the U.S., the ozone, National Ambient Air Quality Standards. Then I testified again in front of the U.S. Senate Committee on Agriculture, specifically about the Waters of the U.S. rule. We've taken both or 2 of those even further. I would join a lawsuit with other states on the Waters of the U.S. rule, and we are in a lawsuit with 15 other states to ask the EPA on 111D. So what does So 111D, for those of you all who are not as familiar, essentially this is on carbon emissions, and why is it so important to Arkansans to care about this final rule of the EPA on carbon emissions? Because if this rule goes into effect, it will skyrocket every single person's utility rates. That those costs to implement and to be in compliance with the EPA standards will be the utility companies will put in these measures, and then those costs will be passed on to every single consumer. The EPA has gone far beyond where it was ever supposed to go on these rules. And that's why we are working very closely with the Attorney General of West Virginia to push back on the 111D, because Arkansas consumers, it's going to make it more difficult for us to attract businesses to places such as Garland County or anywhere in the state, because that's one of the first things that businesses look at, is how competitive are the utility rates in that state? How competitive are the taxes? But the first thing they look at is how much is it going to cost me to do business? And for those of you all in the room that are business owners, that's what you have to look at also. Next, the waters of the U.S. I don't know if anyone had the opportunity to read the editorial in this morning's Democrat Gazette talking about the waters of the U.S. rule. I am adamantly opposed to waters of the U.S. rule. I was raised on a cattle farm. I'm engaged to a row crop farmer. But it doesn't just affect our farmers. It affects all Arkansans and landowners. Because What the EPA has done in the Waters of the U.S. rule is gone way beyond the authorization that Congress gave the EPA. It's gone way beyond what the Supreme Court of the United States stated with regard to the Clean Water Act in the Waters of the U.S. So now, what would have previously been considered a dry ditch in the back of your property that maybe if it rains a good two solid weeks in April, you might have some water running through it. Now, the cause that could, quote, contribute to the navigable flow of water will fall under the federal jurisdiction of the Environmental Protection Agency and the Army Corps of Engineers. Absolutely out of control. This could affect almost all of Arkansas because of the wide scope. We are hopeful that we will be successful in the lawsuit led by my friend, the Attorney General of North Dakota, but I can assure you all that you have a very strong advocate when it comes to pushing back against Waters in the U.S. or this 111D and at the Attorney General's office. And to help me with all these fights that we're going to get into on your behalf, because we are going to take the fight to them if necessary, then I have announced and recently hired Arkansas's first official Solicitor General. We're very excited about this position. This Solicitor General will be the chief legal strategist for the Attorney General's office to work with me, the chief deputy, and the deputies of all the divisions on cases. It may be a case in the criminal division handling criminal appeals that might be a case of first impression. But exciting for me and exciting, I think, for you all in this room is that Lee Rudosky, that's the gentleman that will be our solicitor, Lee has in-depth experience fighting the EPA when he was in a private firm. Lee was a Harvard Law Journal graduate. He clerked for the Massachusetts Supreme Court. He clerked for Federal District Court. He has extensive litigation experience, but predominantly he has that extensive litigation experience fighting the EPA on behalf of businesses and individuals. Lee also worked for, he was counsel for Romney for president in 2012, and Lee has been working for Walmart in Bentonville for the last year and a half, 2 years. And so we are just really excited to bring his experience and his assistance to help us on these major cases that will impact every single landowner, every single person in Arkansas. And then last, some of the things that we are doing to at the AG's office I'm so proud of to help individuals. You know, when I've traveled across the state for the last couple of years, and that's why we have a metal theft program, is because I listened to people and said, what are the big issues? And once we realized and we looked at the laws and talked to to develop things and to do things with the platform of the AG's office that are not being done elsewhere. And the big thing that you all probably hear the most about or most concerned about are some of our consumer issues. Scam artists, con artists, identity theft, internet crimes. If you have not signed up for the Attorney General Consumer Alerts, please do so. I know that some of you all have extensive mailing lists. I see you on the third row. And I appreciate your emails. And thank you for your prayers.
Thank you.
But I know that some of you all have extensive email lists and that you're on Facebook and that you share information. So I would ask that you sign up for our consumer alerts and to share that information. Share that information with your friends and neighbors. All too often, Arkansans and many of us are prone to share information about, I went and visited my brother, I went and visited my sister, or here's where I ate dinner. But why not share information about how to protect one another from these con artists and scam artists? Whether it's an IRS fake phone call, publisher's clearinghouse sweepstakes, someone that's a bad car dealer that we've gone after, a number of scam artists and con artists, that is our business. And to go after those folks. The AG's office handles roughly 7,000 complaints a year from consumers. I want to increase that number. I don't want to increase it because I want more con artists and scam artists. I wanted that number increased because I want more of you all and your friends and families contacting us to let us do the fighting for you. And that's why we have going out, we started the mobile offices. Our very first mobile office was in Hot Springs Village on the Garland County side of Hot Springs Village. And we have done that across the state. I believe now we've hit 40, well, I've lost my notes, but we've hit 45 counties, I believe, thus far, 42 counties, and we will be in all 75 counties by the end of the year with our mobile offices. Because I know that when you're dealing, you've been scammed, or you don't want to get back on the internet, because these con artists, their websites are so good now, they look like legitimate government websites. You don't want to get back on the telephone because you've just been conned or scammed on the telephone. And so having that face-to-face conversation is so important, and that's why that, and I believe that there's no issue too small that we can't have that face-to-face conversation about. It's why we're doing the mobile offices. Also, we've started the, I call them Rutledge roundtables. We have had one here in Garland County. We're doing these across the state. When I worked in college, I flagged traffic for the highway department. And I did that for 2 summers. It's very hot work, so you can, but very rewarding, because the lesson that I learned during those 2 summers flagging traffic was sometimes there was a disconnect between the engineers in the shop and the folks out on the road. And I want to make certain as Attorney General that there's not a disconnect between those of us who happen to work in the capital city and the citizens that we serve and the communities that we serve. And so that's why we've made it a priority to do the mobile offices, to do the round tables. We're also, as Chairman mentioned, we started the Military Veterans Affairs Initiative to have round table discussions, to go out, to ensure that the men and women who have fought so hard for us are not taken advantage of, that we are fighting just as well as men. A couple of other areas, Medicaid fraud and abuse, that's part of our office. We have ramped up, and as Chairman mentioned, so yes, I did kind of think, I didn't know you were going to come roll that good stuff. That we have, by adding certified law enforcement officers, that's not adding people. We've just had the positions now that we have always been in place are now held by certified law enforcement officers. That has increased our ability to have better investigations, to make more arrests, to hold those people accountable who are taking advantage of our Kansans and taking advantage of the system. So we have seen an uptick in our number of arrests, and hopefully we will decrease the number of people who are taking advantage of Arkansas taxpayers. And lastly, our cyber crimes unit. I'm very proud of our cyber crimes units and Special Investigations Division. They investigate and go after individuals who look to prey on children online. I know that you all are all online. Please learn how to use the technology that your children know how to use, that your nieces, nephews, grandchildren. It may seem overwhelming, but it's worth it to know how to use all the technologies that they know how to use, because that's the only way that, as parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, that we can protect them, is to be able to take that smartphone out of their hand and see who they're talking to. Our agents have made over 50 arrests and have had over 2,000 years in convictions since the inception of that program. But we can have all 174 people at the Attorney General's office investigating those crimes, and it still would not be enough. So I encourage you all to learn how to use that technology. So in summary, whether it's metal theft programs, cyber crimes, Medicaid fraud, consumer issues, or fighting against an out-of-control federal government and an EPA, I can assure each and every one of you all that we are doing all we can, and we're going to continue to do all we can, and we're going to listen to you. So you all know me. You know how to email me. You know how to call me. Call, let me know what the issues are, and let me know how I can help you. So thank you guys so much.
Questions? Anybody have questions?
I do.
As long as it's simple, short.
would be number one.
Everybody's all about this gun control because of the idiot in South Carolina. I mean, they don't even want a Taliban coming down to Georgia. Is there any way, the real disconnect is hooking the mentally challenged person with the database for people who can't get guns? And that is a problem of HIPAA. And is there any way to get around that so you can get the information into the criminal type database?
Well, there are a number of issues. I don't think that we can have that sort of information available, and I don't know that having that information would necessarily stop the crimes, because it is the mental illness that we're dealing with.
But you can't get the information, does it?
And I understand that. I mean, there's nothing that we can do at the Attorney General's office, and so that's going to be a question for your Congressman Bruce Westerman. I don't think that that's going to change. I do think that having individuals who are aware that people, you know, we've seen time and again in these situations where someone has expressed and made comments, you know, much like if a child has made a comment to a teacher that you're required to let law enforcement know or required to share the information. And that may be the direction that we're heading, is that if someone has made disturbing comments about their desire to commit such criminal heinous acts, that there is a required reporter of some degree, but right now there's not. So I don't know how or when that's going to be changed. On that note, I will say that I am a strong advocate, as is our governor, for mental health courts and veterans treatment courts. I've talked to a number of veterans about having something on the driver's license, noting that an individual is a veteran, so that way, should a law enforcement officer approach that individual, then they will know that perhaps they may be suffering from PTSD or some other ailment. And so we are taking a number of things into consideration. I just don't know that that's something that is going to be solved overnight.
How do you sign up for the consumer alerts?
How do you sign up for the consumer alerts? ArkansasAG.gov. That's ArkansasAG.gov. And there should be a link on there. Judd, it should be
up at the top.
Sign up. So I just want to make sure the website hasn't changed since I saw it last. So that was a simple one. So I'll one more. If it's a hard one, I'm walking out.
It's not a question. I just want to tell you how proud we are of you and the job that you have done, and your character has been impeccable. And we also know that there are some Democrats.